Hi everyone, welcome to my video essay. We may aware that costume is an essential element in film production. It is helpful to distinguish characters and probably indicate the time, geographical location, and culture background of the story. In this video essay, I'm going to talk about how costume plays an important role in storytelling by using the film In the Mood for Love as an example. In the famous Hong Kong director Wong Kar-wai's popular film In the Mood for Love, the protagonist Su Lizhen has worn more than 20 different types of Qipao in the film. Qipao is a type of traditional Chinese fitting dress that has over 100 years history. It peaked its popularity in Hong Kong in the 1960s. In this film, Qipao not only being used as an aesthetic device, but also indicates the location and timeline that the story takes place. Most importantly, it helps reflect the inner world of the protagonist. The film In the Mood for Love talks about a married woman Su Lizhen and her neighbor Wen discovers that Su's husband and Cho's wife betrayed their marriage. While they explore how their spouses have been cheating together on them, they fall in love with each other. However, they are restrained by their morality and do not want to stoop to the level of unfaithful spouses. Su and Cho's relationship could be divided to three stages: unfamiliar, familiar, and separated. Qipao plays a significant role in indicating the relationship between Su Lizhen and Wen in each stage. In the beginning, Su Lizhen and Wen are known as neighbor. They live in their life circle without too much interaction. We can see that, at this time, most of Su's qipao are dark-colored, green mostly. The patterns are majorly assembled with stripes and squares. For example, this qipao, which is black alternating with white stripes, the patterns of the dress look more like a cage that locks Su inside. She is conventional in her attire. Her husband is busy at work. She usually orders takeout food from a local wonton shop and eats alone. The repeating scene of buying food has shown three different qipaos, but all in similar color and pattern. The changing of costume indicates the time passing. However, the similar qipao and behavior have reflected her plain, lonely, and boring life routine. There is a significant change in her costume when her husband brought her a new rice cooker. The special material of her qipao would change its color along with the changing of light. The flowing colored qipao flows to vivid bright orange in this scene, such like the little change in her life. After Su Lizhen and Wen figure out their respective spouses are cheating together on them, they start having more interactions. They enter the second stage of their relationship. In the scene that they share perspective in their marriage, Su wears the same flowing colored qipao as the rice cooker scene. However, after being more aware of the dark side of her marriage, the color of her qipao is no longer bright, but flows to dark green. Dark green has occupied the majority of the qipao, which illustrates her failing faith in her broken marriage. Su's Qipao has changed 5 times in the scene of Su and Chao dining in the restaurant then walking home together. Similar technique as the takeout scene. Qipao indicates the passing of time. In this scene, it shows that they have been hanging out together multiple times already. In their first dining, Su wears a blooming flower qipao that she usually wears at work as well as other formal places. For the 4th and 5th time, her qipao shifts from the baby blue qipao with a giant blooming daffodil to the stripe-patterned qipao again. She's aware that Mr. Cheung is attractive to her, but she tends to be respectful to her marriage. Therefore, she puts herself back in the cage again. They are involved in each other's life after knowing that they share similar interests in reading and writing martial arts novels. While they get more familiar with each other, Su's qipao becomes more colorful and plentiful. One day, Su and Chao are working on their novel together. Suddenly, their landlords come back. Su has been trapped in Chao's room. Since they cannot be seen together by their landlord to avoid the gossipy neighbors. In this scene, Su wears a salmon pink qipao with chaotic curved rope patterns. This pattern reflects her complicated attitude to Mr. Chao. Although they frequently visit each other as a friend before, she feels consigned to be seen by her landlord this time. This means that Mr. Chao is more than a friend to her now. Nevertheless, later, her unusual behavior caught Su's landlord's suspect. And she suggests Su focus more on her own husband. After then, she starts avoiding meeting Mr. Chao. She stands alone in front of the window and wears the same daffodil qipao. In this frame, the daffodil blooms alone. In visual, it tends to grow to across the window. The daffodil represents Su. She wants to break the frame of her marriage and the limitations surrounding her. In the end, Su didn't go to Singapore with Mr. Chao, although she really wants to go with him. She visits Mr. Chao's apartment in Singapore without telling and meeting him as her way of farewell. In this scene, she wears a semi-transparent sapphire blue qipao, which fits well with her mysterious behavior and her no way of guessing inner thought. Su Lizhen's delicate costume has enriched the layers of the film. They are helpful to build Su as a round character who has a fertile inner world. Adding details on costume is also a cinematic technique that has been frequently used by directors. It allows the audiences to explore the deeper meaning of the world behind the screen by themselves and get more engaged with the story. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it and have a good one. Bye!